أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. This is Imam Ammar greeting you for Eid al-Adha. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from all of you and bless you and your children and your families in this Eid and bring in happiness and joy to your life. Allahumma ameen. The celebration of a Muslim is part of his ibadah, part of their worship. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he moved to Medina, he found that the people of Medina were celebrating 2 days. So he said, what are these 2 days? They said, Ya Rasulullah, these are the days that we used to celebrate before Islam. He said, Allah has replaced you with better days, the day of Fitr and the day of Adha, the day after Ramadan and the day after Hajj, two after a great ibadat in Islam. So we should show happiness and joy in our life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قُلْ بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَبِرَحْمَتِهِ فَبِذَلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَحُوا. Say, by the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they should show joy and happiness. The day of Eid al-Adha has so many sunan and a reminder to all brothers and sisters. The first reminder for a lot of people who will be praying at home is to pray Salatul Eid with your family or in congregation with your friends and families as much as you can, inshallah. If you cannot perform it at a masjid close by, or if all the masajid are not going to perform Eid, there are 2 rak'ah to start with without khutbah. You start with takbirat Allahu Akbar, and then you do 7 takbirat after the first takbirah. Then you read the surah al-Fatiha and surah, and then you make ruku' and sujood. Then you stand up from the sujood, Allahu Akbar. When you get back up, you do 5 takbirat after the coming up takbirah. So that's 6 total. Surah al-Fatiha, another surah, ruku' and sujood, and then you finish your salah. From the sunnah of Eid that you take a shower and you perfume your body and your clothes, and you dress the best of what you have. If you're going to perform Eid outside of your house, then it's better as a sunnah to delay breakfast after you come back so you could eat from your sacrifice if you're going to sacrifice, or at least eat when you come back. It's different from Eid al-Fitr when you eat before you leave to show that you have broken your fast. From the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Eid al-Adha is that you switch route. You go from one direction and you return from another direction. Part of our ibadat is to show that happiness in our life, to bring in that celebration to our life or our festival without doing anything that is haram or forbidden. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from all of you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept your sacrifice, your prayers, and everything that you do solely for His sake. Allahumma ameen. Wa kullu amin wa antum bakhayr. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And happy Eid to all of you.